Hey, people of the internet here, welcome to some coverage of the newcomer tournament from July 25th. This is the best of five grand final, kicking off on Ashes of Typhon. Say hello to Dashi with a brother captain, a very durable hero who walks through objects and cannot be suppressed, some powerful disruption and support fighting in melee. Up against, it's Raven with another big fella, it's a Chaos Lord. Durable and destructive hero, walks through objects and cannot be suppressed. Some powerful disruption and offense. We have the World Eaters Elite Scheme. Maybe we'll see that funky dreadnought with the tail. Newcomer tournament then. Not sure what to expect in terms of, you know, quality of play, but apparently it was quite good. Good enough, in fact, so that there was accusations of heresy, also known as Smurf accounts, being used. I assume since these guys are finalists that at least one of these guys was accused. I'm not sure if any of it was proven. We'll see. More heretics up. These guys, I think, yeah, they use Stormtrooper masks with the World Eaters Elite Scheme, which is fun. I like the idea of Stormtroopers going absolutely mental. Dropping their guns, picking up some dodgy swords, and exploding themselves. Just Strike Squad up then for Dashi. These guys can more than hold their own in melee in Tier 1. That banishment will be very painful for the heretics, potentially, as well. Looks like the brother captain is going to run into some heretics on the east side. I'm not sure what the criteria was for the newcomer tournament, like how many hours or whatever. I think there was some discretion from the organizer in Akura. I mean, I haven't played 1v1 since 2010. I'm sure I could have got in and maybe won a single match or something. Used to play Tech Marine back then. Used to play Tech Marine, then I played some Tyranids. Didn't actually play Chaos until Retribution came out. Did not see the glory of Chaos on the Plague Champion until that last expansion. Double Strike Squad from Dashi. Brother Captain is getting stuck in. He's trying to chase down some Chaos Space Marines with his Power Sword. Weird bit of rubble there flying through the air. CSM are trying to get into melee with the Stormtroopers, and Heretics are being cut down at range by the Storm Bolters of the Strike Squad. Now they're focusing down the Chaos Lord a bit, I think. But the Captain's getting some hits in. Raptors on the way for Raven. Solid choice against Double Strike Squad. I mean, it's going to be quite dicey in melee for them in Tier 1, but you jump in, get that suppression, and maybe Heretics and the Chaos Lord himself can follow up there. The VP of Dashi was decapped. Needs to grab it with the Strike Squad here. They both have the Tomes of Titan for that banishment. Didn't see it thrown out there. Also both have that purification, of course, so they can give some energy back to each other or maybe to the brother captain. Or the Stormtroopers. These guys use their energy for stuff when they got upgrades. Just saw the Raptors there. Jump troops. There we go. That's suppressed when they land. 30 DPS melee. Yeah, so 1v1, they should be able to deal with some Strike Squad, I think. If they jump into two of them and start getting meleeed by both, that could be dicey. But the captain gets a decap. Now getting some shots in, though. He's going to have to retreat. That's a big... It's a long retreat there for that fella. Going to break some stuff on the way back, I'm sure. What is this? Oh, Strike Squad running into some Heretics. Unupgraded Heretics are going to get chopped down by Strike Squad. But now, they should be dealt with, thanks to the Raptors and the CSM here. Yep, couldn't get a decap. Stormtroopers grab the contested VP, go after the decap on the power now. Any war gear up? No. I guess you wait Tier 2, eh? As a Chaos Lord. I don't think you get the Combi Flamer against Double Strike Squad. Was expecting a bit more aggression there from Raven. Tried to get on the power, perhaps. We got Interceptors on the way for Dashi. Not seen those guys on the field for a while. I quite like those guys in Tier 1, of course. Started in Tier 1 when Ordo Malleus, or Grey Knights as they were back then, were first introduced many, many years ago. But then they became... I think they became a Tier 2 unit, and then a Tier 3 unit, and now they're back in Tier 1 again. And we're going to see him here. They can get straight onto the CSM, shut those fellas down. And also be more than a match for the Raptors, since they do the same DPS and have more health. A dicey jump then from the Raptors. Didn't have much support. Now the CSM join in. Here comes the Chaos Lord. Raptors getting knocked around. So were the Strat Squad. And they do get away. And still not seen the banishment used. Expected to see it thrown in there as those guys landed. I mean, why not? Free damage, right? Free instant damage. The Raptors did drop a model. Interceptors came in. Don't think they actually got any attacks in, but they did do their fancy little teleport to show off. Stormtroopers getting a decap now. Brother Captain will come for the mid, and these guys, I assume, decap over here. Nope, they might be going to teleport straight, get straight onto the VP. Tier 2 for Raven. Can they get the Bloodcrusher out quickly enough to make a dent here? I think they can. These guys are going to flank these Heretics. I'm not sure it was needed to bring all of this stuff here against these Heretics. Might be able to get a squad wipe though. Maybe that was worth it. Going to get it with the Bolt of Fire, I believe. Yep, they could have got Cap in. But I think it was perhaps worth it to thin out the Chaos stuff. Get that kill, because without them, with just the Strat Squad there, we wouldn't have got the kill. I wonder what they will do with the CSM in Tier 2. Mark of Khorne to counter-initiate the Interceptor jump, perhaps. And they'll do very well against the Strat Squad, of course. But the Captain's got his Nemesis Force Sword for the improved We Are the Hammer. It's got 40 power melee DPS. Used to have 50 power melee DPS, that thing. Looking for the jump, the Raptors. CSM might get intercepted too. Still no sign of the banishment. Am I just not spotting it? Expect to see it whenever it's off cooldown, really. It is a Bloodcrusher from Raven. There's the teleport. Still no banishment. There we go, we saw one. Looks like it got a decent hit as well on the Raptors. A staggered jump there, having to retreat out. More Strike Squad joining the fray. Chaos Lord with a kill the weak. His starting ability. A disruption and self-heal all in one, which is pretty damn useful. Can he get a model off these interceptors with his default sword? I don't think so. That was a good special though. Can't use Kill the Weak again, but here comes the Bloodcrusher. Might have retreated a bit too late, and did retreat a bit too late. Bloodcrusher can go and poke the power now. Or maybe just scare these fellas off. Tier 2 for Dashi imminent. More Heretics up here for Raven, since they were all gone. Triple cap for Dashi though. A solid end to Tier 2, but now has a Bloodcrusher to deal with. Lots of great choices, of course, in Tier 2 for the Ordo Malleus these days. Can get a Vindicare Assassin, can get a Rhino, can get Purgation. Nothing yet. And we are seeing the Bloodcrusher going after the power. Might be able to get one of the generators. Can shrug off the Bolt of Fire mostly. I mean, it is a vehicle, but it's only got 600 hit points. Can't take Bolt of Fire forever. But can take enough of it to harass the hell out of these fellas. Does good single target DPS, a Bloodcrusher. 90 odd, heavy melee. Tearing these guys apart. Not sure why they all piled into melee with this fella. I guess it does more than the piercing DPS of the Bolters, eh? Actually did quite well against the Bloodcrusher there, all of them. There was a little bit of power melee from the Brother Captain too. Raptors jumped in and got wrecked. Almost taken out, in fact. Chaos Space Marines do have Eternal War, but no mark, and they need that mark to really be a big threat to this Ordo Malleus Grey Knight stuff. It's a Grey Knight Dreadnought on the field for Dashi. The Strike Squad being really strangely split up here. They might go down if they're not careful. Chaos Lord finishes them off. A little bit sloppy there from Dashi. We have a Grey Knight Dreadnought going for the Multi-Melter, so short range, good damage to all targets. It's kind of like a big laser shotgun. Big chunks of damage. Got that very mean-looking close combat weapon too. Plague Marine's on the way for Raven to start cracking missiles at this guy. Nothing else though, really, to deal with it. I'm not sure if Plague Marines are going to be enough that he can just close the distance and get into melee with them. We shall see. Blood Crusher needs a bit of worship support, and here come the Heretics running back to HQ. And it's actually faster to repair it, I believe, in terms of getting its health back. Here are the Plague Marines, have that snaring missile launcher. Very slow but quite tough with their health regen and just massive pool of hit points. They don't have a great armor type though, with infantry armor, which is, you know, weak to most things like piercing damage even. So they don't like bolt of fire or other small arms, especially when it's massed up against them. Terminator Librarian on the field now for Dashi, with its Sanctuary can help against Raptor jumps. And a Grey Knight Dreadnought should be more than enough to deal with a Dreadnought with a Multi-Melter on it. Just put it in melee mode, have it chase around and shoot that thing. I think it's better off to try and split that Blood Crusher off, try and get flanks or maybe get onto the power. That was the first Plague Marine shot we saw. Need to get them moving while they're reloading, ideally, so they can get the next shot in. They're ready. There it is. Some repairs from the Stormtroopers. Chaos Lord took some hits. We've lost the indicator for him. Just a bug from replays. No war gear there. Absolutely no war gear. No more war gear for the Brother Captain. He's still level 1, the Chaos Lord. Interceptors. Oh, sorry. Strike Squad just got their Justicar. Interceptors already have their Justicar. And the Terminator Librarian taking a bunch of damage. We do have the Mark of Tzeentch from the Chaos Space Marines. I would have gone for Mark of Khorne because of the Interceptors being around. But I guess, yeah, Sanctuary is quite annoying for melee troops. Not sure why they moved so close there, actually. Just shoot him. Bit odd. Blood Crusher is fully healed up. Where are the Heretics? They be decapping, and now capping. Gonna get intercepted. Or Furious Intervention, as it's called. There it is. Knocks you over when you have the Justicar. Got messed up, but it should be okay. Interceptors hit level 2, though. Chaos Lord is onto the east side. VP 337 to 199. Tier 3 for Raven. Decent amount of resources, too. Not that far off a tank. Needs 450, 125-ish. I think it's worth it. Should be able to keep the distance against the Dreadnought with the Multi-Melter. I mean, vehicle pathing does have its issues, but with the Plague Marines slowing it down, should be able to keep maximum range. Maybe we'll see Melter Gun Raptors as well. Pick your targets now. What has he gone for? He's gone straight for the Brother Captain with the Mark of Tzeentch CSM. Did some good damage there. Now try and focus fire this Librarian off the cap. Taking a lot of damage there. Got the decap. Needs to be very careful. Throws out the smite. It's a good hit. Barely gets away though. I don't think you need to be so focused on this cap right here. It was decapped. Could have tried to tide things up, but couldn't quite get it done. Raptors jumped in there as a deterrent. Blood Crusher, I think, could be used a little bit better here as a flanking unit. I mean, I guess it doesn't want to flank until the Dreadnought is committed to the back lines, but at least get ready for it. Meanwhile, Interceptors, with their grenades now, are decapping stuff. And it is a Predator tank on the way for Raven, a Chaos Predator, I should say, I guess, and another Grey Knight Dreadnought for Dashi with another Multi-Melter. I don't think we've seen this thing fire its Multi-Melter yet. 311 to 151, just hasn't got close enough. Been very patient with his Dreadnought so far. Interceptors, Furious Intervention on the Heretics again, but now they got to fight a Blood Crusher, and they can't really do that. 311 to 139. The march of the Dreadnoughts, now that they have two, much more confident just marching in here. The Plague Marines can't shoot them both. There we saw the Psychic Burst slowing down the Chaos Lord. That's an ability given to the Strike Squad by their Justicar. Did they hit the Plague Marines there? I don't think they did. Don't think they did. Getting some hits on the Dreadnought though. Maybe one more. I'll need to get them moving as soon as they fire. Here comes the tank. Getting a bit too close. A bit too close there. It's gone for a Mark of Zeench, which is the anti-vehicle variant of the Chaos Predator. And it's doing some good work, as you can see. Can the Plague Marines get another shot in? Their pathing's been messed up slightly by the tank. There we go. They are slightly better these days as an anti-vehicle unit in terms of their missile launcher firing a bit faster. They also rotate a bit faster in the latest update. Down goes one of the Dreadnoughts. And this one's going to be in trouble now. Tank got a big chunk of XP just from that. Did basically all the damage to the Dreadnought. I mean, the Plague Marine's got some hits in, of course. And he got some XP too. What is this? It's the Interceptors being used as a capping unit on the west side now. Bloodcrusher can maybe tie up the Dreadnought so it can't fire the multi-melter. Nope. Gone for the infantry. It's gone for the repair support. It's a good special. Sanctuary there from the Terminator Librarian, but it's going to go down. Lost sight of him. Bloodcrusher is going after the Dreadnought. And with the Twin Link Las Cannon, it's not going to last long. That's probably GG. I mean, it's got a lot of VPs to make up, but just wrecked the Ordo Malleus army. Another Dreadnought on the way, but we've seen that Raven can deal with them. Triple cap though, into the double. Can they get the VPs back quickly enough? Maybe they can't. Are you guys decapping? I'm not sure if you guys were decapping quickly enough. Chaos Lord is capping this, and it might cap just in time, maybe. Wow, it's going to be close. There is the one-to-one cap, stops it at two VPs. Can they keep this momentum now? And stop a single cap for 310 VPs. Stop conceding a single cap, I mean, because just 2 seconds of that, and they've lost the game. Here's another Chaos Predator on the way for Raven. First one's done pretty well. Here comes a brother captain though for the cap. Oh, Markov Zinc CSM choosing their targets on the interceptors and just really shredded them there. Canticle of Absolution, giving health and energy regen to your units, but still got stabbed to death by the Bloodcrusher. And the Grey Knight Dreadnought is going to go down. That's a melee variant Dreadnought there, which is a very strange choice against a tank and another tank. This one doesn't have a mark. Dash it down to two units. And there is the concede. Raven takes it with just two VPs remaining. And there's your game one. I'll see you in game two. All right, game two, innit? We're on Sival Frontier. Raven and Dashi, both the same heroes. I guess there was no rule against using the same hero twice in the same match in this particular tournament. Raven with that Chaos Lord then, and Dashi with a brother captain. Raven taking the first game because they had tanks, and Dashi was super vulnerable to tanks at that point. We still got those World Eaters too. Some more Heretics on the way, and Strat Squad up for Dashi. No changes there then in the opening engagement. Might see it kick off a bit sooner though. Brother Captain and Strat Squad versus Chaos Lord and CSM. Who wins? I assume it's the Brother Captain because of We Are the Hammer and Strat Squad winning in melee, but they're being tied up by the Chaos Lord here. Those guys take the garrison. I assume these guys are going to take the garrison too. They're going for it. It's kind of beat up, but it will hold them for now. Those guys then pop out, start shooting the brother captain, who goes after the Heretics. Where are the other ones? They are taking this VP in the southwest. There's a big line of points on this map. No natural VPs. Can you kill a heretic? Oh, you've killed one. Well done. Got a bit of XP, as you can see. Smack killed another one. You murderer. Not sure what the heretics are trying to achieve other than just annoying the brother captain a bit. And dying. And then blowing up. Can you kill a strat squad fellow? You can't quite kill one. Stormtroopers. That burst firing hotshot las guns. I think that was only two bursts. And look at a heretic's health. I mean, they only have 75 hit points each. Bless them. And they are prone to explode. It's not easy being a heretic. Got more strat squad up here for Dashi. Not sure what they're up to. They're just going back to base right now. I guess they're waiting to push as one for the brother captain and stuff. Heretics decapping the mid. And heretics going for the northeast, which hasn't been touched yet. Just had a bunch of fighting up there. Chaos Lords found some stormtroopers. Can he get them off the decap though? Nope, they got that decap. It just matured to 30 as well when they decapped it. Double banishment. Didn't see enough of this in the first game. In fact, I think I only saw a single banishment in the whole game, or only noticed a single banishment. I wonder if they were just being used every single fight. I just missed them every time. But that was a good usage of it. Got those CSM out of there pretty quick. Not sure what the cooldown is on banishment. But the heretics should be safe. They're all running away anyway. Those guys did grab the northeastern VP. Just a single generator up. Oh, there we go. More for Dashi. And three up here for Raven. Into some Havocs, I would think. Last time they got Raptors, which did okay. Havocs is the safer choice. Can draw Interceptors in and counter-initiate them. And really shut down the Strat Squad, of course. Although, Sival, it is easy to flank the setup teams because it's so open in the mid. Did a good job getting out on the caps. But now has to defend said caps. Where is the Chaos Lord? There he is. He's got his Combi Flamer. I mean, it will help pick off stormtroopers at range. Does not upgrade his melee weapon, right? I don't think it does. Not like the enhanced custom shooter of the war boss, which I think gives him a slightly better melee weapon. I think. Heretic's barely getting away. Doing some good work though. I said in the first game that I didn't think it would be super useful against double strat squad, but it's doing some work here. I mean, that damage adds up as you're chasing stuff around, I guess. There's killed a weak. Dodged really well, actually, by Dashi. And they're going to take the Chaos Lord down because of that. Gets instant repurchased. TSM are close to dropping a model here. Not sure why they're sticking around. They're trying to get some kills on the Stormtroopers, I guess. And now go for the Garrison. But the Captain can't do much about that. Not sure why these guys are backing away. Oh, they're going to defend the power. This strike's got, I don't think, dropped a model. If they did, it's been reinforced. Still nothing up for Raven. They go straight to tier 2, you know. I mean, it's decently poised to go straight to tier 2. Dashi really didn't really power the pressure on and has spent on the tomes. Are they spent on anything else with their power? Not really. They have the weird firing pattern, the Storm Bolters of the Strike Squad. Very tight, controlled bursts of fire. You guys gonna shoot those fellas? They're gonna go for the decap. You can chuck your banishment on them. Maybe. There's a decap. Perhaps couldn't see them like we could. Might see a double banishment here. There we go. Oh! Holy crap. Six models down, lucky to get away. If they were slightly closer and could instantly shoot afterwards, they might not have got away. I'm not sure what you meant to do about that with your heretics, aside from giving them an aspiring champion so they don't die so fast. They thought they had it bad with warlocks. So not too far behind the tier 2 Dashi. Here comes a Bloodcrusher, as we saw in game 1 from Raven. There's that Combi Flamer, that low rumble of the Combi Flamer. Terrifying for Eldar everywhere. And apparently makes Strike Squad back away too. Not sure why the Brother Captain's not fighting here. Should be getting in on the CSM at least. There's the Psychic Burst. I think they did chain it together. I thought they used it twice at the same time, which would have been bad. Now they're just running into melee. Because he can't use his kill to weak. All his energy was taken away. And there's the kill. Nicely done by Dashi. I guess that's why they were backing away, just trying to lure the Chaos Lord in as they were waiting for those Justicars to finish. Worked out well. Maybe they can shoot some power too. Here's the Blood Crusher though. A Bloodletter on top of a Juggernaut with that Hellblade and heavy melee damage. I think mostly the Juggernaut does the attacking, like bites and headbutts people. Oh, messed up the charge there. Charged right into terrain. Purgation is up with silencers. Good damage to all targets. Doing some good work there, as you can see, against the Bloodcrusher. That really messed it up. 388 to 444. Another Psychic Burst. Chaos Lord's having a rough time close the distance now. They've set up well for this Bloodcrusher. Surprised the damage the Purgation did there, since they aren't really burst weapons, those silencers. They're like constant DPS, which is generally not great against not ideal against vehicles. You want that big burst of damage. So as they try to escape you, you're still delivering all the damage of that single burst, although Bloodcrushers, with only 600 hit points, maybe made the silencers seem better against vehicles than they would against something else. Another walker, for example. Now going to fight a Brother Captain and make him flee. How's he going to live that down? He's almost level 3, this fellow. We've got Bloodletters on the way for Raven. Those guys are bad news for all of this Grey Knight stuff. Very bad news. If they can get onto the Purgation, it allows the Bloodcrusher to get in and do this kind of thing too. Takes out a model. Chaos Lord with no more war gear yet. Heretics found some Stormtroopers. Caught them. They did take some damage as they came in. There's a banishment on them though. Can they get a kill? Maybe. Purgation do need to set up with the silencers. Couldn't quite get it done. Aspiring champion up on those fellas though. Have we seen any worship at all from Raven in the two games? I don't think we have. Heretics were busy, very busy getting decaps and stuff in the first game. It's been quite similar here. Here are your Bloodletters. Demons with power melee weapons. They will slice through the heavy armor of the Order Madius Grey Knight fellas. Chaos Lord goes down again though. There's the teleport. Teleport right on you and do this. Look at the damage. Holy crap. Oh, special attack stops them getting into the garrison. And they're going to wipe. There's the wipe. A clutch special attack there. Stormtroopers have their sergeant, so they can chuck a grenade. Banishment thrown in from the Strike Squad. They have the Psychic Burst, of course. Still. Grey Knight Dreadnought again from Dashi. I say again, we saw it in the first game. We saw, was it three of them? Yeah, I think three of them in the first game. Starts off with this big old flamer. And that power thing. Power stabby thing. Is that even a real weapon from the tabletop? Or did they just make something that looks cool here? Bloodletters having to reinforce. Brother Captain gets a cap done. Level 3. Chasing down the Heretics. Is it worth getting his big old Ordo Malleus baseball bat to smack the Bloodletters around? It might save a unit. Is it worth the expense though? Here come more Purgation. I guess they have to deal with that Bloodcrusher somehow. Rhino was maybe the way to go. Would have kept a distance and the Bloodletters wouldn't have been super effective against it. But we see Purgation again. I think Rhino would have been the way to go. After losing the Purgation, get the last kind of Rhino. There's that fire. Bad news for bunched up Heretics. Got some decent range on it, isn't it? There's some good damage to the Bloodletters too. Where is that banishment? There it is. Onto the CSM. Bloodletters teleporting. Here come the Purgation. They have their incinerators, but they did switch to the silencers. Setting up here. And the Dreadnought getting some hits in. But the captain's in a bad place. Not sure if he's being paid attention to. Should be now with everything else off the field, and does get away. Blood Crusher's done some work here. Plague Marines up for Raven. Does not like the Havocs, eh? I guess stationary Havocs with a Las Cannon or something would get double banished, and then the Brother Captain would just run into them. Oh boy. Poor Heretics. Those weren't the fellas with the Aspiring Champion. The Grey Knight Dreadnought trying to chase the Blood Crusher in melee. Looks like it's going to be alright. Chaos Lord's still down, of course. He's gone down a couple of times, maybe three. You can be expected to remember these things. Here are your Plague Marines, of course, leaving a trail of muck behind them. They do slow down enemy units if they get close enough. It's not very much. It doesn't seem to make a massive difference, but it's a nice little bonus. Not sure how much it slows them down. I don't think it's... Maybe it's half. Half a point of speed, maybe. Nemesis Force Halberd on the way for the Brother Captain. It might be a percentage, like 10% or something. Going for that splash damage power melee. Double banishment again on that CSM blob. Couldn't quite get a hit there, the Dreadnought, but does get two fine hits on the Bloodletters, and down they go. Missile launcher getting shot, but they are persuaded to leave. Purgation decided to stop fighting. Oh, they get some shots as they run away. Something weird with the graphical effects of the tracers. They kind of only seem to go halfway for the Purgation squad, which is a bit weird. Very quick power bash. We now have a Plasma Cannon Dreadnought. Has a twin linked heavy bolter and a Plasma Cannon, which is a hell of a lot of fun to use. For the fella inside, well, what's left of the fella inside. Chaos Dreadnought now, maybe the Mark of Zinch. 2-3-1 to 3-9-4 on the VPs. Dashie needs to get tier 3 going, I think. They got lots of red, if they can get Paladins on the field. Got to be GG. Here is the Dreadnought. It's gone for the Mark of Khorne. Does have that cool tail. So it's going to take some damage on approach from the Purgation, but if he can get in and pop that Blood Rage, maybe this Blood Crusher could charge those guys and draw some fire, draw the attention of the Dreadnought. Maybe went a bit early, but the Purgation have been knocked over. Here's the Canticle of Absolution, giving health and energy regen to Dashi's units. I don't think it doesn't affect vehicles, I don't think. Here comes that Mark of Khorne Dreadnought. Can pop its Blood Rage, giving it more damage resistance and more speed, but you lose control of the Dreadnought. Can be used for some bloody fun once you get in there. What is this? It's the Blessed Aegis. Also have the Unending Purge. Health when he hits infantry, which is quite handy, and the energy regen break for his shield, of course. Oh man, Plague Marine is getting exploded. They can't stay here, guys. There we go, run away. Dreadnought did some good work for Raven there, smacked through a bunch of Strike Squad. Here comes some more Heretics. There's the Underslung Bolter getting some shots in, can't do much for Dreadnought, but here it is. Closing in for melee. It's in its melee charge, so it does get at least one hit. Does it chase it into base here? Probably not with the Purgation around. Oh no. More Purgation with a conversion beamer. Kind of like a Las Cannon, looks like Raven is lagging. And if you use the Electro Pulse ability, which costs energy per second, you get that snare. Does more damage the further away you are, but it's enough to take out the Dreadnought. with the help of the silencers, of course. GG says Raven. Big VP deficit, just lost the Dreadnought, and the Blood Crusher ones are going to do much either with the conversion beam and stuff around. So there it is, 1-1 now in the series. I'll see you fellas and ladies in game 3. Welcome back to game 3 and that. It's 1-1, which is exciting, isn't it? Dashi is sticking staunchly to the Ordo Malleus brother captain with these ultramarine colours. But Raven, neglected to shower for a while, has gone for a plague champion who starts off in ranged combat with a damage over time bolt gun, can get melee weapons with strong utility and support. We have the Death Guard. Elite scheme. Look at him go. Seems like a very plague champion-y map, really. This is Fen Dunlock, which I'm very excited about because I haven't been able to cast this map yet. It's got a 1v1, 2v2 and 3v3 version. One of Swift's maps, I think, in the last update or the update before that. Not the last one, a little bit before that. But yeah, it's very swampy. What have we got going on? We have a natural VP in the north for Raven, natural in the west for Dashi, and contested VP over in the southeast. In fact, it kind of looks like the same layout as Quest's Heresy, doesn't it? A bit. Something switched here and there. And shifted around. We have Heretics and CSM and a Strike Squad for Dashi. Nothing different there in the openings then. Heretics being chased across this makeshift bridge. They've got away. Looks like we do have some garrisons here and there. And more Strike Squad for Dashi. Loves that double Strike Squad. I mean, we saw the Banishment do heinous things to the Heretics in the last match. I was expecting maybe not double Heretics this time because they had a rough going with that Banishment. Plague Champion making the Brother Captain stink a bit, but he was tied up in melee. And as I've discussed before, the Plague Champion is horrible in melee by default. Inexplicably having 8 DPS in melee combat. Despite being a, you know, millennia-old Chaos Space Marine. Get it together, Elite Mod developers. Give him some more melee damage, please. Got less than the Mech Boy. A little orc fella that can teleport around. Strike Squad's Banishment you just saw there, messing up the Heretics a bit. It's when you double it up, though, that it gets really dangerous. Here comes the Brother Captain again. Gonna pop that We Are the Hammer. And they're focusing on the CSM. Painful Banishment for those fellas. Plague Champion doesn't start off super tough. As tough as you'd expect, perhaps, a Plague Champion to be. You can focus him down quite quickly. He's very slow as well, of course. Might sound like the Plague Champion is really bad, but he's actually really good. Despite having no melee damage and not lots of health. I mean, 680 is not bad for a ranged hero, I guess. I prefer him to be, like, tougher and even slower, I think. But there's a reason why I'm not in charge of how slow and tough things are in this game. We've got some Raptors up for Raven. Saw these fellas in the first game. Did some good work. We'll see how they do here, eh? There's a jump. Well, couldn't quite get close enough to the Stormtroopers. But I think they killed a model there with their bolt pistols, which looked kind of cool. The enemy falters, but he is not yet beaten. Strike Squad do some capping. And the other fellas, again, be a capping. Yeah, Raptors need to be careful jumping into both of them. Is there a minimum range for your Banishment? I think there is. Maybe we'll see here. They banish the CSM. Man, it feels like that's doing more damage these days. They do get a damage boost when the Justicar comes in tier 2 on the Banishment. CSM, yeah, back off and cap, guys, because if you get shot just a bit on the wrong model, You're gonna lose one. Plague Champion has gone 40 mucus discharge with Breath of Nurgle, which heals him and nearby allies. That doesn't smell very nice. 479 to 457 very early on. Looks like they're all piling in to the VP here to defend it. But the captain's off. Grab that VP. I thought it'd go mid, but looks like they want to get back to the west side super quick. Should be off harassing units as they join the fight, I think. Because with the banishment, with double banishment, you can push against this pretty well. There's some Nurgle Worship, some health regen for Raven's units. Just hanging back here, dashing, waiting for the brother captain, maybe. Oh, he's decapping. Oh no, he's fighting heretics. There we go. Takes a while to get through him, doesn't he? But he'll get there. Oh, a CSM died. Not sure why they were pushed forward. I guess to shoot stuff, but they lost the fella now. Big champion's out of cover. Bad position. Not sure what he was trying to do. Can't push alone against double strat squad fella. Tier 2 all around. Looks like Dashi has gone first. But the captain taking some melee hits on retreat. Can they jump and finish him off? They didn't even try it. I think maybe they could have. Maybe. I mean, over 100 hit points. Maybe not. If they got two hits each, it might have been enough. Not sure if they could have, though. They can't really jump twice super quick. They have a 60 energy jump, I believe. Unless they level. Jumped over the banishment. That's one way to avoid it. But now, can they take on double strat squad in tier 1? Got a good special. That's going to help. But now they're eating specials. Here come the CSM to help out. They're trying and focus on one of the strat squad to drop a model. But, yeah, Raptors got dealt with there. Dropping two of them. Might be able to get a Breath of Nurgle in there, I said, but those guys both got their Justicars up. Where is the banishment? He now upgraded banishment because of the Justicars. Heretics coming in from the other side. Strat Squad really holding their own. Took out the Heretics there. These guys are getting very low though. Doesn't need to keep them in. Well, they got chopped up so fast by this strike squad. They did eat a banishment on the way in. Man. Did some really good work there, strike squad fellas. Lost both of his heretics then, Raven. Those guys didn't get away. Blood pressure on the way. Those fellas taking the garrison. 452 to 418. Lots of action around this central power point here. Taking the bridge now towards the contested VP. Both players with three gens up, of course. Haven't seen a power bash. Or maybe we saw one over here? I don't know. What did you say? Why are you talking to me? Did you get an upgrade or something? Maybe they did. Stormtrooper's gonna maybe get a triple cap here for the Ordo Malleus. There's a single. Gonna very quickly be a double at least. I'm not sure if they can do it because the jump's gonna come in. But you've got a decap, fellas. Well done. Blood Crusher and Dreadnought. Much like the first two games. Dreadnought coming out before the Blood Crusher, though, is not a good sign for Raven. And with that Flamer, I think they should be heading straight to the power here. With some support, of course. And do have the double strat squad up with the Justicars, the brother captain himself. Kinda hanging around. Can certainly annoy this stuff by tying it up, but the Blood Crusher, as we've seen, will do some good DPS to that guy. Smack, 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 smack. Raptors get their aspiring champion. Does have that heavy melee demon wall. Seem to jump through the little wall there. I mean, it's a makeshift wall. Banishment flies in, but they don't want to stick around for the suppression and the blood pressure. And here comes a melee plague champion. Look at this. Gone for his plague sword. Ignores melee resistance and creates zombies if it kills you, which is fun. More dreadnoughts for Dashi. Loves these Grey Knight dreadnoughts. And more heretics or Raven. I guess you do need some repair and worship support, especially for that Blood Crusher. Are you guys going to actually use your jump here? Nope. And the dreadnoughts there to counter-initiate those fellas. I mean, they do have that heavy melee weapon, but they don't really want to fight a walker in melee. I mean, these guys don't have melee resistance by default, I don't think, but still, it's a dicey fight. Especially if you're not maxed out on hit points. Not sure how Raven is going to hold against this. Especially when the second dreadnought comes in. Get some Havocs. Where's those las cannons? I mean, I've said before that double banishment on the las cannons could be really bad, but need to stop the march of the dreadnought somehow. Maybe like the first game, they can get plague marines and then stall until tier 3 tanks. It's going to be a big ask. There's the jump, but it's a jump into lots of trouble. Because now we have double multi-melt dreadnoughts. You saw what they did there as they jumped in. 430 to 328. There's the 2-to-1 cap for Raven. And there's this. These guys taking a very, very circuitous route around to the VP. Gonna get on it, I think. But the captain gets the cap. And I think Dashi should try to preserve units and go tier 3 here. I mean, triple dreadnoughts sounds pretty fun. Looks like Raven's maybe going straight to tier 3, not getting something up in tier 2 to try and fight these dreadnoughts. Just going to try and delay. Might lose all their power though. It's been a bit chasey here, Dashi, kind of chasing units around rather than using the massive advantage they have to get on this power and take it out quick. The Plague Champion is going to die. There's a Noxious Cloud. Very, very stinky. Those guys should be splitting, but I guess they're fast enough to just get away from it mostly. And we're going to see a quick Power Bash. And capping is the Brother Captain, although Heretics grab the VP here. There's that Smite, or whatever it's called, Banishment. Maybe they're out of range. Raptors on the VP here too. I mean, Raven's doing what they can until they get their tier 3 tanks rolling. And they're not that far off it. Not that far off it. Gonna get a full bash quite easily. Not a whole lot they can do about it. Yep. At least the Dreadnoughts can't decap, hey Raven. Yeah, we're not gonna see the Plague Champion for a while because they want that tank up. Doesn't have the 250 requisition to spend on the old Plague Champion. Is that being built? That is being built. Trying to switch their power to the other side. Looks like Dashi is maybe just going after it here. Should be taking this opportunity to cap and decap everything though, I think. 404 to 327. But the captain grabbed this VP. Got no war gear. Heretic's going to get the natural back. Strat squad, oh sorry, Stormtroopers on the VP here. And they have indeed come to have a look at his power. It's only a node. And as you might expect, they're going to make short work of it. There we go. 404 to 313. VP lead for dashing. It's perhaps not as large as you'd expect. Been very dominant in tier 2. They've kind of labored the capping and the decapping a little bit. Really want to fight stuff. I mean, I understand wanting to fight stuff. Who wants to cap? Where's the fun in that? They could have just gone into base maybe and just wrecked stuff with the two dreadnoughts. I mean, it's so risky though. You never know when a Plague Marine or a Las Cannon is going to come out suddenly. Here is the Chaos Predator for Raven, but Dashi well into tier 3 themselves. Could get some Paladins up pretty soon. Needs a bit more red and a bit more of the other things, but not that far off, especially when they can kill stuff pretty fast like this. So we're going to see a Mark or Zinch Curse Predator most likely. Needs some power for that though, isn't it 30 power? I think it's 30. What is this? Oh, Heretic's just ready to cap stuff. at some point. 2-1 for Raven still. They're keeping this core of the two Dreadnoughts and the two Strat Squad very much together, which only leaves the Stormtroopers and the Brother Captain to run around and cap stuff. And they are doing it. In fact, Dashing might get a triple cap here. And here are your Paladins. Have those Nemesis Demon Hammers, which are heavy melee weapons. As you saw there, make very short work of those two Chaos Space Marine fellas. One of them got away to tell the tale. Heretics will come in and decap this, I imagine, when this guy runs off. Level 3 Brother Captain with the Holy Armor of Titan, giving him the Immortal ability. Makes him invulnerable for a while. Like 9 seconds, isn't it, or something? 382 to 278, there's a triple for Dashry. Is the tank enough to get this going? Markov Zinch is in. Those Laz Cannons looking for a Dreadnought. Boom. Did they chase it? Oh, that hit a Strat Squad model. Blood Crusher's not going to last long there. Goes down pretty fast. But if Raven can keep on top of this tank pathing, should be able to avoid any multi-melter hits. It can't avoid the Paladins if they teleport on it, though. It's chasing. I think the Paladins should teleport on it. There's no Marco Zinc CSM to really threaten them. Or at least make it back off like that. There we go. Heretics did get the decap. Banish doing some good work in retreating, though. Kind of Paladins finishing them off. Not sure if they're quite quick enough. Not sure how much damage these guys do in ranged combat, actually. I wonder how it compares to Space Marine Terminators, you know. Because Assault Terminators for Space Marines don't get a ranged weapon. CSM. Getting messed up. Really messed up. They were just trying to hide, I think, over there. There's that triple cap for Dashy. Raven is reeling. Not sure if this single tank is enough. Especially with the Paladins. Just couldn't get onto Dashi's power. Ouch. Raptors getting banished. And then dying. And that is surely GG. Okay then, says Raven. Yep, going to be 2-1 for Dashy. Going into potentially the final game. Best of 5. What do we get? A level 3 by the Captain with the Nemesis Force Halberd. And a Portal Plague Champion. Never got back up again. Just wallowing in a swamp there. I'm sure he's happy though. I'll see you guys in game 4. Well, 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 what's after game 3? Yes, it's game 4. We're on Calderas Refinery. 2-1 at the moment for Dashy. They could sew it up here with a victory. Raven's gone back to the Chaos Lord. Are we going to see double heretics against double banishment again? So they all fall down. Perhaps. Let's watch his requisition to see if it all disappears. Yep, more heretics on the way. There it is. We'll see how it goes, I guess. Newer players, perhaps. More married to their opening. They're tried and tested openings, eh? And are we going to see double Strat Squad? We'll see if a node comes up over here. If not, probably double Strat Squad. Are the Heretics going to stick together? I guess this one's going for the VP. This one's going west. No son of a node. Could be slightly delayed. Nope, no node. I don't think we're going to see anything other than more Strat Squad again. Lots of banishment incoming. Chaos Lord's going to run into some Stormtroopers. They could just run away. But who wants to run when you can be knocked over by a terrifying Chaos Lord? Can you get a model off him? Go on, son. Not quite. He's very upset. Where's the blood, he's saying. Definitely no node. So we're going to see that Strike Squad. Here they come. Double Strike Squad it is, but the Captain's going to run into some Heretics. And smack. Strike Squad hanging out mid, grabbing the VP. Heretics don't really want to go there. 478 to 500 very early on. Get that first VP quicker, I guess. Did Dashy. There's the Doomblast. And here comes another Doomblast, maybe. A little bit early on that Doomblast, but I guess maybe they were worried about just everything dying. Uh-oh. Like that. Got a sync kill from the Brother Captain. Ouch. That sword is about the same size as the Heretic there. Sergeant up quite quickly this time from the Stormtroopers, and they did that. Heretic's having a rough time already. No sign of the Tomes of Titan yet. 478 to 500 still on the VPs. Kill the weak. There it is. Now can tie up the Strat Squad. CSM needs to flee. Or just run away. Ouch. Took a lot of damage on retreat there, but miraculously did not drop a model. Dashi needs to bash his own power to get it back here. Goes into melee with it. No special attacks against the node, please. Noise Marines this time from Raven. Haven't seen them yet in this matchup. Have a sonic blaster that can shake structures apart. Also, disable ranged weapons and ranged attacks. And do some good damage too, especially to the Stormtroopers. But if they find bunched up Strike Squad, they could do some work. Stop them banishing things. Perhaps, although they could probably just throw it out before the Noise Marines get into range. Got the VP. They don't want to fight them. Even if they get into melee, they can get cacophonied and knocked over. Triple Strike Squad for Dashi. It's got to be an Overwatch mistake. Good grenade there on the Heretics. Some comedic domino knockback. Amazingly, none of them died. Now they have. Kind of noise when he's getting a little burst of the Sonic Blaster hit. Nope. Those dastardly Stormtroopers started moving. It is triple Strike Squad for Dashi. I wonder if that is intended. Can just go into melee with one. Make them use their cacophony and shoot with the other two, I guess. Nope, they're all just going into melee. Smack, 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 smack. Surely gets one model here, maybe. Yep. I mean, those halberds are really cool looking weapons. For a, I guess what would be a basic tier 1 melee unit. Strike Squad are pretty good, but you'd expect those halberds to be way more painful than they are. 478 to 453. Tier 2 for Raven. And they should be looking for, yeah, aggressive power bashes here, Dashi. Not seeing anything after the Noise Marines suggests to them that Raven's going for the tier 2. Take away that power as soon as you can. There we go. Not the best bashes around, but I'll get it done. There's three of them. Brother Captain takes the mid as the Chaos Lord takes Dashi's natural. What is this? Those are the Stormtroopers. Here are your CSM. Heretics grabbing that rec point there. I think they're going to get it all. Not much of an attempt by Dashi to, by Raven to stop this. And Noise Marines have run right into the Brother Captain. The one thing they don't want to be into melee with, because they can't knock him over with their cacophony. Doesn't mind the noise. Smack. They're going for the power, of course. But it's a bit heavy-handed, just running towards the power with the Brother Captain chasing you. Here comes the Chaos Lord. Can they get away? They only need the single model to fire that Sonic Blaster, of course. But that was Stormtroopers in retreat path. Grenade misses. These guys now getting into melee with the Stormtroopers, and the grenade has already been used. So they know it's relatively safe, although the Brother Captain is chasing them. Doing some good work. Lots of those attacks went on the single model too. Tomes of Titan on one of the Strat Squad, two of the Strat Squad, all three Strat Squad have that Tomes of Titan. 478 to 383. Killed a weakling as a single model. I mean, this gives you some health. Actually doing well. Since he's in melee, he would be taking less damage. I think it's 40% less damage from range attacks. That's a trait that nearly all units in the game have. Some guards from the infantry doesn't have it, I don't think. I wonder if the stormtroopers have it, actually. Bloodcrusher on the way from Raven. We've seen a Bloodcrusher first out in Tier 2 in every game so far. And they have generally done quite well. They should do quite well against triple strike squad that can't really touch it. Can charge into them. Open up attacks for other units. You know, like Noise Marines. More power bashing here. I guess there's not much else for them to do. They could be capping and stuff. That's probably better off decapping here, than all of them bashing a single contested node. I think. Here's your Bloodcrusher. Very excited to get attacking stuff, isn't he? Breaking pipes. Those could be useful as well as heavy cover for your own VP there. Noise Marines are... What are they doing? I thought they were going the long way around to the power or something. Bloodcrusher against triple strike squad. I mean, we saw double strike squad get into melee with the brother captain alongside them. We do some good work to the Bloodcrusher. I imagine, yeah, nine of them couldn't all get into melee at the same time though. There's not enough space. Dashi is in tier two. And they need some anti-vehicle. So what are we going to see? No war gear for either of the heroes. Noise Marines are going to get themselves onto the power. Bloodcrusher is positioned to defend here. I think they should have moved them a little bit further here and gone this side of the power. A little bit more protection from what's coming, which is going to be a bunch of banishment, I imagine. But I guess they wanted to get bashing as soon as they could, eh? And some good decapping from Raven, too. No, didn't see a banishment. Did see a big demonic roar from the Bloodcrusher, though. I guess they're all looking to get... Yeah, we've got two Justicars up already. Here comes some purgation. Ouch. That would have been so nasty on those CSM, the triple banishment. I think only one hit before they retreated, though. There's that psychic burst on the Chaos Lord, though. Yeah, draining all of his energy. He just got that kill to weaken in time, I think. And a conversion beamer. Is bad news for the Bloodcrusher. And I assume they're going to just pop their Electro Pulse immediately. There's a Canticle of Absolution. Yep. Getting snared, which means Electro Pulse is active. And now they need to get moving to finish it off. Although, Strat Squad might be enough. No, they stopped chasing. 441 to 292. I think they should just get chasing there. Might have been able to finish it off. Maybe. Only had 50 odd hit points. We have another Bloodcrusher here from Raven. Attacks one of your structures. How is this? Trying to get that power back again. Chaos Lord did fall over. Twitching. He's ready to go. He's eager to go. Here's Raptors now for Raven. Could be a shrewd choice. Jump those Purgation. Bloodcrusher a bit more free to wreak some havoc. Or wreak some havoc, I guess. You know, words. I think maybe let the galaxy burn. Just set fire to all of the Strat Squad. If he can get back to his feet, that is. Some repairs for this Bloodcrusher. The other one is on the way to the west side. Purgation are covering the mid. They could turn and get some shots onto this guy. So that's what they're going to try to do. While the CSM cap the mid. Are they going to set up? They're getting way too close to this thing. They're going to be tied up here. They should be tied up. There we go. Here comes the other Blood Crusher and a bunch more Chaos stuff, including Raptors with their aspiring champion 403 to 285. There's a jump. Ouch. Heretics all fell down really fast because of the double banishment that went in. Chase him into base, I say. All you have to do is fight the Purgation, and they can't do much to you with double Blood Crushers. I probably would have chased in. What's this now? But the captain's being chased. It's a Rhino from Dashi. Most likely with a Las Cannon to fight these Blood Crushers. Chaos Claw is still down. The Las Cannon does cost power these days. Used to be just 75 requisition. But that was a bit mental. I think it's 15 power. Still well worth it. Raptors have taken some damage, but I think their suppression and being able to get onto the Purgation is pretty damn useful. I want to keep them around. Here's the Rhino. Starts off with a Pintle mounted Storm Bolt, which isn't that helpful, but does allow it to reinforce off it. There's a jump. Gets onto the Purgation. Blood Crushers be fighting stuff and killing stuff. They both used the Demonic Roar at the same time, I think, there, which wasn't super useful. Last Cannon is on the way. Raptors are going after it. They do have that heavy melee weapon and maybe get onto rear armor, but they just got banished. Oh, hey. Blood Sacrifice, which is going to kill all of the Raptors, unfortunately. But now there's some Bloodletters getting stuck in. They are ripping apart the Strat Squad there. These are temporary Bloodletters. They will disappear back to the warp when their energy is done from the global bar of the Blood Crusher, as you saw. Global bar of the Chaos Lord, sorry. Pretty good global. Can turn an engagement around, but now they're gone. And the Rhino is making short work of any Blood Crusher it sees. This one got away. So that was a topsy-turvy fight, let's say, for Raven. Sacrifice his own Raptors to get some Bloodletters. I guess, yeah, they didn't expect them to all die. But it was a big risk to try and use it there. Can Raven get back into this game? I mean, the Blood Crusher's dealt with, right? Because there's no Raptors anymore, so there's the Conversion Beamer and the Las Cannon. This thing is going to have a rough time. Tier 3 for Raven. And this Blastmaster could do some real work against blobbed up Strike Squad. And Dash's economy, because of the Justicars for everyone, is a little bit slow at the moment. Especially if they start dropping models. But the captain's down over here. 377 to 232. Chaos Lord still down. Who needs heroes when you've got banishment? Rhino wants to make sure it's facing the correct direction. Doesn't want to show rear armor. Decent hit with the Blastmaster there. But here comes the banishment. One, two, and there's the third. But they did retreat for the third one. Raven's not that far off a tank, but it's going to get power bashed here, I assume. Pretty hard. Maybe. Are you going to shoot? Just looking at it. There we go. Here comes the Blood Crusher. It's going to get purgationed though, isn't it? Smack. Yep, it's not going to last through this fight. 334 to 232. I was going to say maybe it was worth running the Blood Crusher up to the power and bashing it, but I guess not. Surely Dashi has this. Surely. We see victory here. Triple cap. Here comes the tank, though. The tank can take out the Rhino quickly. Avoid the Purgation. There's hope. Slim hope. heroes are still down, twitching. Doesn't quite have vision, does it? Oh, it does have vision. Well, that was a pretty effective shot. I think it actually hit rear armor there because of the arc it had. Oh, it was just fire. It was just targeting, blindly targeting, I think, where he knew the Rhino was. And hoped it was still there, and it was. Decent hit. Not sure how they get in vision here. Is the power giving them vision? I don't think it's close enough. It's going to be a Mark of Khorne Predator tank, which just boosts the damage of all the guns there. 210 to 232. One hit here will take out the Rhino. It's not being repaired. It's not being moved. It's showing real armor. It's very sloppy from Dashi. Takes out those heretics though. Now the Rhino's being repaired, but it should be leaving. He knows there's a tank. Big hits from the Blastmaster, and there's a nuke. Imperial Abyss called in from Dashi. Does some good work there. Down goes the Rhino. Rear armor hits though on the tank from the Strat Squad. Is it enough to take the tank down? What the hell? Dashi just lost almost their entire army. Only has double Strat Squad. That was so sloppy. I mean, it's a newcomer tournament, so let's try and be kind. But should have been repairing the Rhino way quicker. As soon as they saw the tank, should have been backing the Rhino the hell away. The nuke, I guess there wasn't a huge amount they could have done about the nuke. If they just mass retreated, it would have been worse. They all would have retreated through the middle of the abyss. Dashi might have just lost this game. They have basically no power income. But they haven't been building generators because they haven't had the requisition for it. And now they have no army. Raven has turned biggest turnaround and quickest turnaround I can remember seeing. They still need VPs, of course. Purgation on the way for Dashi. Too little too late, I think. What a crazy ending to this match here. Not over yet. It is not over yet. But the captain's going mental. He's got a Nemesis Demon Hammer. And now he's dead. Okay. Purgation. What are they going to do exactly? Get some silencers. Do you repair? Or do you just cap? I think you just cap here, Raven. But they are repairing. Chaos Lord's going to go for the VP in the mid. Dashi is fighting on. Not sure exactly what they intend to do. It is silencers on the way. Bit more generalist than the conversion beamer. Not sure what this guy's doing. This Heretic Spiron Champion having a tactical meeting here with the Chaos Lord. Double repairs for the level 4 Chaos Predator. That must be the fastest leveling tank ever. They should be using their rending for more damage versus, there we go, against heroes. Makes them all explodey, look at that. Gets the cap, no, doesn't get the cap. Little misplay there from Raven, I think they had the time to get the cap there. But they're going to be forced off the field anyway. And Dashi can't drop a nuke, they're not in tier 3. 23-232. I thought we were going to see a 3-1 victory there for Dashi, but looks like we're going to go into the fifth and final game here. Nuts. They're going to get a triple cap, and Dashi most likely will just give up here. Because now there's a tank in your base, a level 4 tank at that. Malignant blindness there from Raven. Doesn't want to get sloppy though. Doesn't want to lose that tank. Going to be a triple cap here for Raven, and surely they have it. There it is. Chaos Lord comes back out. Do you get another tank up soon? Now, actually, no sign of it. The damage those shots are doing at level 4. but the captain must flee. And it's another Rhino for Dashi. Nothing for Raven. Maybe they want Terminators up, they're just waiting for the red, perhaps. I'll just get another tank. Let's get another Mark of Corn tank. Not giving up though, Dashi. Not giving up. Here comes the Chaos Lord. Still no war gear for this guy. Give him some war gear. Canticle of Absolution in base to heal up faster. Or maybe, yeah, to get the energy back for the shield, perhaps. There's your Rhino. Last cannon's on the way. Don't think it's going to be enough, buddy. Location are down. Here are some Chaos Terminators now. Some friendly fire from the Blastmaster. And down go the Heretics. Got your Chaos Terminators here. Yet more friendly fire, but they did take down the Rhino. And there is the concede from Dashi. Massive turnaround over here. Crazy. Some sloppy play from Dashi, but Raven didn't give up. Got the tank, got the nuke, got it done. And it's 2-2 in the series now into the fifth and final game. And I'll see you then. Welcome to the fifth and final game in this newcomer tournament final. We are on Calderas Desert. Raven with the trusty Chaos Lord and Dashi with the ever-present Brother Captain. Old pals at this point. We got some CSM and we got some Heretics. No change there for Raven. Dashi with, of course, a strike squad. Are we going to see two? Maybe we can tell from the nodage. Brother Captain grabs it. And there is no node. So maybe again, we're going to see the double banishment wrecking the Heretics. Seen it every game so far. I think we've only seen a Chaos Space Marine mark once, haven't we? In the first game when they got Marco Zinch. Maybe they got it one other time. I think they only got it once. Brother Captain pop in, we are the hammer. And smack, smack, smack. Chaos Lord just left this fight. He's had enough. He's going for the decap. Oh, he noted it. Look at that. What if that was in response to the Chaos Lord going for it? Or they actually intend to get something else up here? What would it be? What is Dashi going to do? Uncharted territory. We saw a crazy turnaround in game 4 from Raven. Dropping a nuke and getting a tank at just the right time. It is more Stormtroopers. A little bit late on the Stormtrooper. The second one coming out there. But here we are. Stormtroopers it is. Heretics are bashing the node. I think they're going to get it. Even with the Strat Squad closing in. Tomes of Titan on the way. Chaos Lord chasing those guys. And Stormtroopers chasing the Chaos Lord. Now can you use the banishment at point blank range? Maybe we'll see. Oh, you can. You can indeed use it. Surely there should be a minimum range on that thing. That doesn't seem right. Is there a minimum range on the Destructor? I don't think there is. Or on the regular Smite. But that seems a bit odd. Just like in melee with Banshees or something, just throw the banishment at your feet. Maybe that's intended. To help them out in melee fights. I'm not sure. 474 to 500 very early on. Chaos Lord doing a good job holding up this entire army, but is persuaded to leave by, you know, Stormtroopers shooting at him. Raptors on the way for Raven. We've seen Raptors, isn't it? I think 4 out of the 5 games, I think. Heretics couldn't quite get a decap. Fully matured wreck point there. But the captain, meanwhile, is on the contested power. The natural VPs aren't supernatural on this map. They're quite close to the mid, so should be able to get some decaps pretty regularly here. I assume all this stuff is shot blockers. But the captain gets it. There's that banishment. But there's only one, so they can stand and fight a bit. Can they get a model off them, actually? CSM are decent in melee, but they don't want to stand against the double stormtroopers. Not sure what the heretics are going to achieve here. It's too much stuff. Maybe they can doom blast these guys and scare them off. They can scare them off, you know. Wow, was not expecting that. Well, that's all they can achieve. They can make everyone run away with their terrifying doom blasts. I think the strat squad should have stayed in play there and gone into melee with the heretics. Would have been super risky, but with the stormtroopers helping, they could have torn through the heretics quite quickly there. Maybe wait for the banishment to come back up. They took the safer route and ran away. Now it's the raptors capping. Now with double stormtroopers, that combi flamer could really pay off for the Curse Lord. No war gear for the brother captain yet. And no upgrades for the stormtroopers yet. A grenade on those approaching heretics would have kept them in play, I think, if they could hit it. There's the tier 2 for Dashi. We've seen a dreadnought right out in tier 2 every single time so far, I think. But it's going to take them a while to get the power for that this time. Quicker tier 2 this time from Dashi. Trying to leapfrog in tech while Raven invests in raptors. Or could have waited maybe for the heretics to close and hit both of them with the banishment, but would have been risky. Didn't know where the raptors were going to jump. And those stormtroopers got torn up. Get the aspiring champion, I say. Would really help approach the stormtrooper fire. Got the captain now joining the fray, going for a power bash. Is Raven smacking on the heretics. Cursed Lord just gets in the face of the army there, tries to keep it off the defense. They couldn't quite bash anything. Raptors safely jumping out. In fact, yeah, they didn't take a single point of damage there. Got some more heretics, could be going for this wreck point. Fully matured. Looks like they are going for it, but they might run into stormtroopers here, yep. And they turn to go after him. A single stormtrooper with no upgrades can't really keep them at bay. But they're going to get some help here, yep, from that. Good old banishment. On the way are purifiers, awesome. First time we've seen them in this final. Power melee squad will chop down the raptors, you would think, pretty well. And a brother captain can support them very well too with his war gear, with his ward and that kind of thing. Raptors shouldn't still be in this fight. Gonna drop a model. There's a jump. Need to run away now. They're still chasing those stormtroopers. Are they gonna fight their brother captain a little bit? Smack. Is it enough to get a model though? Looks like maybe they're going to get away here. Have I cursed them? No. They didn't drop a model. Well done, fellas. Well judged by Raven, let's say. Here come the purifiers. They have their Justicar, who has a heavy melee Nemesis Demon Hammer. Other fellas with power melee weapons. And they're pretty damn tough, as you can see. 2150 hit points at level 1. A force to be reckoned with here. Killed a weak from the Chaos Lord. Maybe should have waited until he lost some health to do that, but I guess all he's doing is delaying them a bit here. He can't really fight them. Maybe we'll see the Lightning Claws now. Although, generally, to counter melee stuff, you want that Blood Maul for the knockback. And stun. Blood Crusher for Raven. Seen it every single time in Tier 2. And they will do some work here, even though those guys have a heavy melee weapon. Need to stay away from the purifiers if they can. Bloodcrusher does not have melee resistance, I'm pretty sure. So the purifiers are actually a pretty bad fight for it. Because power weapons will do some dinks. That heavy melee hammer coming in. These guys taking some shade. Don't have their Justicar yet. We have Purgation on the way for Dashi. Mixing up their army a bit, hey? Compared to their other games. Is it going to be Conversion Beamer? Or is it going to be Silencers? Raptors have their Aspiring Champion. There's a jump. Gonna suppress all three, I think. Yep. Blood Crusher is gonna fight some purifiers. We saw the demonic strength thing used there. Not sure what it hit though. Nothing seemed to go flying. It might have been the Justicar of these guys. I think he was doing a special attack. He wouldn't have gone flying from the demonic strength thing. Demonic Fury, I think it's called. 379 to 370 on the VP's power bash attempt from Raven. And hey, look at that. Some Marco Zeke CSM. And look at that as well. It's the Nemesis Warning Star from the Brother Captain. A power melee weapon with a pretty good support ability. It used to be 83 power melee DPS. Now it's 74.66. And there's the ward. I believe it's 25% damage resist. It might be 30 though. Can he finish off this Blood Crusher? One hit from that hammer should do it, but they get frightened by the big old demonic roar there. But the captain gets away okay. Did you guys get a Justicar? You did. So they can now do that psychic burst thing on the raptors. And Purgation went for a conversion beam up. As you may have seen, get some shots in there. Chaos Lord goes to the VP. Raptors go for the kill stuff. Looks like they're going to stay and fight. Yeah, Stormtroopers not achieving a whole lot here. They could have stayed in play and thrown their grenades, I think. They have their sergeants. Surprised they just ran. Purifiers did take a lot of damage, but they're back out. They do have that longer charge range, I believe. 15 charge range rather than 12, which is fun. Strike Squad do bashing power. Level 2. Tier 3 for Raven. Just ride the Blood Crusher into Tier 3, buddy. Who needs anything else? Hit him with your sword. There we go. He's got some sword animations in there. Killed one. Backs away. Purgation down to two models. We only need one to fire the conversion beamer. Chaos Lord's found some stormtroopers here. Gets a good kill to weak. Are they going to just pile in on the Chaos Lord here? I guess so. Get him off the field, eh? Heretics are hanging out. Now they're going to do blast. They eat a banishment, though. And with the Justicar. That was really painful. Purifiers in retreat path. Couldn't quite get it done. Did you guys level? Nearly. Raven's done some good things with the Chaos Predators when they've got them. Here's the Rhino, though. He's going for that last cannon. Getting ready for the tanks. Canticle of Absolution there from the Brother Captain. One of his global abilities, giving health and energy regen. And Heretics are going to die. Did they die? They did die. I think. Yes, I can't select them anymore. These guys are alive. Oh, wow. Rhino did not last long. Did it actually get the last cannon? I think it maybe did. Raptors and the Blood Crusher got on it there really quick. So the tank is slightly safer. Needs a little bit more power here. There we go. Chaos Predator on the way. Maybe we'll see the Mark of Nurgle this time. We've seen the other two. 347 to 323. It's never a bad choice, Mark of Nurgle, although maybe if you're facing literally an army of vehicles, it would be a bad choice. Some brave stormtroopers hanging out until the Blood Crusher started smacking on their faces. Go for the power. No, does not go for the power. Great time to bash power now, just after you took out a tier 2 unit. Chaos Lord is still down. Raptors level 2. Marco Zinc CSM don't have their Aspiring Champion yet. I almost said Justicar. which is some pretty heinous heresy. 3-2-3 to 3-2-3. Looks like it's gonna be though a double cap here for Dashi. Conversion beam and gets a solid shot and should take out the blood crusher here, I think. Yep. At basically maximum range, doing maximum damage there. And ward up on the purifiers allows them to dig in and swing those swords longer. Tier 3 for Dashi. The Predator is here and it's got the Mark of Khorne buffing the damage of all the guns. If you can catch units bunched up like this, it's a bad news for them because of that autocannon. Conversion beamer though. No electro pulse, doesn't have the energy to use it to slow down the tank. Can they get another shot? They can't, don't have the vision. Chaos Lord's back to his feet. Almost level 2, no war gear for this guy. Gets his natural back. And there's a triple though for Dashi. Gonna be a 2-1. Pegation on the move, not sure where they're going. Just want to stick with his army, I guess. Chaos Lord's not going to be happy about all this shooting. They're going to get him down to half. Not bad. Just going after him though. Got to get him moving so they can avoid the kill the weak. I guess they're watching the mid, are they? Marco ZCSN doing some good work. Raptors are forced to retreat though. But as are the purifiers, no ward around to help them out this time. Brother Captain's just hanging out at this garrison for some reason. Struggling to approach the tank. Now goes for a power bash, and this is risky. You know your opponent has the conversion beamer, which could snare you, allow the purifiers to get in rear armor or something. I mean, this thing is bashing amazingly quickly, actually. So there's the electro pulse shot. Can it get away? Looks like it's broken line of sight there. And does get away. Does some good work, this tank. Heretics grab the VP. It was a brief double cap there for Raven. Getting straight back onto their natural. Stormtroopers are taking it. Because they forced the Chaos Lord off, I guess. Heretics are now repair the tank. Have we seen any Khorne worship from Raven once? I don't think we have. I don't remember seeing it. Seriously. Even when they had Bloodletters on in that one game. Chaos Lord got a decap and runs off. And here comes Strike Squad to grab it. Level 3 Strike Squad too. Bad news for the Purgation. Not sure why they stayed there that long. I guess they're okay. They chase around this little messer here. Not sure why they built this thing on top of it. How do you even get to that thing? Ward is helping those guys out. I wonder if they would have dropped a model without it. It does help against all the damage types, I believe. Still no war gear for the Chaos Lord. Wants another tank, I think. Although, 200 power. Could get a Great Unclean one if you save up some requisition. Maybe some Terminators. Lightning Claw Terminators would do some really good work here. Really good work. Needs a 550 requisition, I think it is. Next purchase is quite important for Raven. Can they keep the pressure up with something? Now bash the power quick. Maybe. And the Raptors hanging out towards the mid. 205 to 272. It is Chaos Terminators for Raven. No sign of an upgrade yet. It needs some more requisition. 70-70 for Claws, I think. Yep. Lightning Claws on the way. It's a bad day to be a Grey Knight right now. And yeah, they're going to struggle with that. Paladins get eaten by the claws. Grey Knight Terminators get eaten by the claws. Get a Dreadnought in maybe. 205 to 247 is quite close on the VPs. Raven with the double and has been controlling the map with his tank. Hasn't been able to utilize the purgation super well, but maybe here. Rear armor. Gonna get jumped though, and they do get jumped just in time. And now they've spotted these Lightning Claw Terminators. What is the plan? Do they get a melee Dreadnought? Maybe. You would mess up the Raptors as well. Problem is, of course, it just gets shot by the tank. They haven't been able to put pressure on it that much. It's been just rolling around for ages here. No repair support. Raptors, of course, getting on the purgation every time they pop up. Bunch of dead heretics there. Strat squad just hanging out. Gonna be a bad day for them pretty soon. Boom, you need to run, guys, I think. Maybe, I thought maybe he was trying to bait the Terminators into using their teleport there. But the tank was shooting them fine. Here comes some more heretics for Raven. Needed heretics as well. Because Worship is great for melee Terminators and, of course, repairing the tank. Worship is just great for everything. Pawn Worship is pretty damn good. Level 3 Raptors. What about the Purifiers level 2? Here's your Paladins. That's one way to deal with a tank. Just put Paladins on the rear armor, but now they have to fight. Lightning Claw Terminators. Ward goes up. Raptors getting chopped down. Terminators went after the Purifiers there, which is smart. Because the ward was on those guys. You saw those guys teleport away. That's how terrifying Lightning Claw Terminators are. Give these guys a aspiring champion, I say. Hey, some corn worship, you guys. Look at that. He's a Chaos Lord after all. So yeah, Chaos Lord doesn't really want to fight the Paladins. Uses Kill the Weak and then leaves. That's in Claw Terminator. Did they just use their teleport? Is that what that was? I don't think so. Paladins thought about fighting him. Oh, there we go. They're trying to get onto the Chaos Space Marines here. Purifiers go after the Claw guys and regret that decision. Raptors jumping in now. The Purgation now not super useful with their conversion beamer. No vehicles to shoot at. Looks like they want another unit up rather than upgrading their resistance stuff. Those guys just being reinforced. Chaos Lord. Gonna go and contest that VP. Meanwhile, Raptors grabbing the mid. 188 to 122. It's very close in his fifth and final game. Not sure what Dashi's plan's gonna be against those damned Terminators. I mean, the tank is gone. So get the Dreadnought, I guess. Right? Are they just going to get a Land Raider Crusader here? And just camp the mid with it? Maybe. If the Paladins and Purifiers can reinforce, they should be able to wear down those Terminators. I guess they could reinforce up a Rhino as well. It is going to be a Grey Knight Dreadnought from Dashi. Oh, Strat Squad fought off the Chaos Lord. So what happens when you have no war gear, buddy? And when the Strat Squad level 4. I don't think they should bring everything over here. Marcos Inc. CSM R level 3. Give them an aspiring champion. It's another tank from Raven. It's another tank. Purgation down to a single model. Grey Knight Dreadnought is going to hit the field and I assume be given the fist. Yep. The Dreadnought Claw, I guess, is on the way. Gotta cap the mid here, buddy. Got a double against you, and there's a Dreadnought. So since the Dreadnought has melee resistance and these guys have power melee, even though they have tons of it, the Dreadnought will do good against them in melee. There's that psychic field, which I think these days like prevents you, it drains your energy or something. It used to do damage over time. I don't think it does that anymore. I was gonna say I think it prevents you using abilities, but those guys teleported out. Maybe they got out of the range of it. That's what that symbol usually means, that Inquisition symbol. Purgation now suddenly useful again. Going for that Marco Zeech tank to shoot down a Dreadnought. There's Malignant Blindness. This could be a vital fight here. Purgation got some good shots in. Paladins go after it. There's that Canticle of Absolution. Claws tearing through the purifiers, but the raptors fall. Do they have enough to whittle down these Terminate as well? Did they get the tank? No, the tank is still here. There's the Emperor's Fist. Terminate is having to teleport away. And the tank is getting some good shots on. Needs to be clear of the Paladins, of course. Using Bloodlust now, the Chaos Lord, giving a damage bonus to his melee units every time they hit an attack. Get a higher damage bonus if it's a melee attack, of course. Oh, it's that fun special attack animation from the Dreadnought there. Just spins the hell around. And I don't think the Chaos Space Marines are going to get away if the Paladins turn around and smack them. 99 to 113. Oh, they didn't turn around in time. They only got one of them. Chaos Terminators can now reinforce, costing 50 power. And the tank, sorry, the Dreadnought, what are you doing? Did not need to lose that Dreadnought there. They still have Stormtroopers that could have repaired it. Strike Squad going for this VP. And the Stormtroopers are going for this VP. What is this? Oh, it's Heretics. They do have their grenade and some backup. Paladins too. 99 to 89. It's kind of an even fight. And the tank is still under threat because of the Paladins and the Purgation. Badly needs repairs, badly. Can't really take it into a fight again until it gets them. And the Heretics, I guess they could just hit retreat after this, get back to base. Here comes a Rhino now. Thought maybe we'd see the Vindicare Assassin getting some shots on that tank, but I guess not. Paladins stay in the field. They do not go to heal up. Killed a weak from the Chaos Lord. Can't do much else. Lightning Claw Terminators are there, though. Canticle of Absolution again to help them heal up a bit. Paladins teleporting away. Means they can't chase the tank, really. Look at this, with the Canticle. Purifier's doing a really good job against the Terminators here. Now the Canticle's gone, though. Yeah, where's your Emperor now? Rhino, with no weapon upgrade yet. A bunch of dead Heretics and stuff. They did barely get away. What am I hearing? Oh, it's this. 46 to 89. Paladins are falling, and they used their teleport not that long ago, as we saw. Marco Zeech, CSM, and that tank are ripping them apart. And down they go. Dashi with the VP advantage. Why did they do that? Just keep them mid. The Chaos Terminators go down. I think they were just about to use their teleport as well. Didn't quite get it. So both the Terminator variants go down. 23 to 89 is so close. Rhino's not going to have a good time against the tank. Down it goes. Purgation trying to set up here. But the CSM tied them up. And they're killed by a Twin Link Las Cannon to the face. Level 3 Predator tank has done really well for Raven here. might have got victory. I mean, they're down to 5 VPs. Chaos Lord, oh, I was going to say he's going to die, but gets killed awake. There's Bloodlust again. Here comes an Orbital, though. Down goes the Chaos Lord. It's so close. Tank moves out of it. Those CSM are done for. Dash here down to just 2 units, though. And the Strats where they're getting wrecked. Level 4 Strats where they're going to go down. Got some Blood Letters called in from the Blood Sacrifice. But there's the game. Dashy got it. Got the cap there. Some brave Stormtroopers at the end, was it? Yeah. Only 2 of them left. I'm not sure what this animation is. I guess it's the Las Cannons and stuff. Pretty damn close there. Could Raven have got onto this VP quicker? Or at all, I guess. Crazy stuff. Level 6 Chaos Lord at the end, had a level 4 Brother Captain. And there's your final. Dashy takes it. With a 3-2 victory, pretty damn close. And a good effort. Well done to the Inakura too for hosting the tournament. Thank you for watching, guys. And I'll see you next time.